dear friends, I'm happy to be here and speak to you a few words on this important occasion of the annual convocation of this university. I offer my congratulations to the graduates of the year who, by active work and disciplined effort, have attained their degrees, and some of them have achieved distinctions also. Your university has had to face many difficulties of an unexpected character. After partition, you had to perform practically a new university, shifting your teaching departments to different centers and starting new professional institutes. Naturally, your colleges have suffered from overcrowding, bad housing, ill-equipped and inadequate staff. These difficulties affect the maintenance of high standards. Yet, the work which you have done in very difficult circumstances must be to you a matter of pride and satisfaction. I hope that in the new capital, whose building has attracted attention far and wide, the university will have its permanent headquarters with enough accommodation for its growing needs. Your chancellor has had great interest in university education, and his experience will be of considerable help to you in your attempts to develop the teaching side and exercise adequate supervision over the affiliated colleges. Building and equipment are not all. Good teachers who are interested in the welfare of the students, who have enthusiasm for their subjects and are able to impart it to the pupils from the central framework of a university. Our commercial-minded generation reserves its respect for those who make money, and so the best ability is drawn into administration, business, and drawn into administration, and the learned professions. We have to realize that the kind of education we provide for our children is determined overwhelmingly by the kind of men and women we secure as teachers. The low esteem in which teachers are held is the most eloquent evidence of the malady from which our society suffers. We must get the right type of men for the teaching profession and not the incompetent and the unambitious. Respect for the teacher cannot be ordered, it must be earned. The new few years, the next few years will be a testing time more severe and more exacting than we have known for many years. Political freedom, which we won at much cost and sacrifice, is only an opportunity. It is not a fulfillment. If we are to develop a strong democracy, political, social, and economic, it is necessary for us to work hard and work unitedly. The idol imposes on us a sacred responsibility. Men are not made democratic by the mere formulation of ideals in the constitutions. They are not made good by mere exhortation. Great ideals of justice, equality, fraternity, and freedom, which we have inscribed in our constitution, must be woven into the social fabric. We must apply them to the numberless situations at our daily life. Unfortunately, the state of mind in which we found to ourselves at the time of political liberation is not marked by revolutionary fervor. The spirit of enjoyment has prevailed over the spirit of sacrifice. We seem to demand more than what we give. There is much evidence of low moral dissatisfaction and discontent among people, all leading to serious slackness. We must overcome the spiritual sickness which seems to be enfeebling our community. If we do not change our minds, we cannot change anything. A nation is built in its educational institutions. Messrs. Thomas and Sons, 20 Market Street, Bombay. Dear Sirs, the order number 567 placed with you 6 months ago has been a source of continual trouble, and we feel that the question of delivery must be clarified at once. In accepting our order, you gave a delivery date in March of last year, thus allowing yourselves ample time for completion. 6 weeks before delivery was due, you wrote informing us that in view of a delay in the granting of permit for metal to complete the body work, you required a further period of 2 months. To this we agreed, although we were particularly anxious to make our vehicles out of service. 2 months later, you asked for a further period of 6 weeks because the metal had been unavoidably delayed on the rail and had not reached you. Once more, we agreed. We now learn that owing to a serious strike at your factory, our order can still not be completed. In future, we must always have a firm delivery date for these vehicles, as the ones which they are to replace are virtually unfit for the road. In these circumstances, we shall, of course, be forced to hold you responsible for any adverse consequences of our continuing to use them any longer. We must now insist that this matter be reported to the managing director, who we hope will take it up personally. Yours faithfully. Please subscribe, share, to our friends who are going to appear SSC examination.